Welcome back to my channel. I'm Auntie Tay. If you guys are new here, that's who I am. And if you're not, welcome back. And you may be over here because of my Mickey ear tutorial that I told you that we would have, the perfect bow tutorial. And I have made hundreds of thousands of bows. I don't know if I've made hundreds of thousands, but I've made a lot of bows. And I've used so many different techniques that I was like, listen, it is time for me to nail down the perfect technique and the one that I love the most and narrow it down and put it into a tutorial. So that's what I did for you guys today. And today is the perfect bow. And I wanted to go a little step beyond and make them interchangeable. So I also have another tutorial on how to change out your bows and make them so that your ears can, let me show you, go easily into completely different ears. Okay, so completely different ears, so many cool things that you can do with these. So if you wanna see how I did the interchangeable part, check that tutorial out. However, today we are talking about the perfect bow and the technique. It is no sew. I thought about making it a sewing tutorial, but it's not my favorite way to make bows. It's just not. It doesn't turn out the right way. It's not perfect. It's not the perfect bow. So here is the perfect bow. So let's get going. For your perfect bow, you're gonna need a piece of felt and a piece of fabric. And I like to use just a regular 9 by 12 inch piece of felt and fold it in half the hot dog way. And there's really no measuring to be done because I found that this is the perfect size for these. So I just cut it right down the middle. You can measure if you would like to, but I generally just do this. So then you need a piece of fabric that is going to be a little bit larger on all sides than your felt. I'm going to iron it with my Easy Press, and I'm just gonna do it right on top of my silicone mat. This is the Auntie Tay silicone mat that I use in lieu of any other mat underneath my Easy Press because it's large and it can resist heat. And I also use it for glue and glitter and paint and all the things. So check that out on shopantitay.com if you're interested in having a few of these in your craft room. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is just lay my felt on top of the fabric, making sure that all the edges are able to be wrapped around. These short sides are not as important as the long sides because we will fold those over eventually. So if you have a pattern, make sure that what you want on the pattern is in the center going up and down. Even though I turn it sideways like this when I'm making it, I need to turn it over and look at it just to make sure that what I want on the front of the bow is going to be in the right spot. And then I take two long strips of hot glue and I just fold over those edges. If that bugs you that I'm using the end of a piece of fabric, you can obviously cut your fabric to not have anything on it. And then I'm gonna fold it into thirds and I'm just going to tack it not through the middle because we're gonna pinch that closed eventually, and not on the edges because I wanna show you what we're gonna do on the next step. So I'm going to take those little corners and just fold them in. This will prevent the bow from having anything stick out of the sides when we do scrunch it together. So this is a little important step. Now I'm going to tack a little bit of glue in the same spots, but on top of the fabric, and fold the rest of the bow over in another third. And then I'm going to continue to do the corners just like I did on the other side. Again, this is preventing it from popping out when we cinch it together. So now we're gonna flip it over and make sure you have the pattern that you want on the front of the bow. And then this is the perfect way to fold your bow. So we are gonna use a rubber band, and I like using rubber bands because it's fast and easy. And we're going to fold it in half away from us from the middle, about an inch down, touching our thumbs together, and then folding one side up so that it goes a little bit higher than the center, and then pull those sides down. And in total, you'll have three little folds on the front. And then we're going to pinch in the center and move over just a little bit to expose the center so that we can get that rubber band right in the middle of the bow. This is one of the hardest parts of the bow, actually, is getting the rubber band right in the middle. So I found that just shifting your hands over really helps. And then the rubber band is just to secure the bow before we put the center on. You can use anything for the center. You can use ribbon or another piece of fabric. You can use the same fabric or different fabric. It's really up to you. I've gone all routes and I like the thicker fabrics because all of my bows are interchangeable, and I have another tutorial on that if you want to see that. So I'm just taking a little piece of fabric, and for this one I wanted mini to be in the center. So if you do have a pattern, just make sure that you work around whatever you want in the center of your bow. I'm folding this into thirds and then ironing it. You can use a regular iron. Obviously you do not need an easy press for this project, but I use my easy press for everything because I just have it sitting out in my craft room at all times. And then I'm gonna pop a little hot glue on this. This is optional, but it helps with the clip if you're going to use a clip. If you're not gonna use a clip, you don't need to hot glue this. So then I'm just gonna put mini in the middle and start wrapping it around. I used a little bit of excess fabric just in case I needed anymore. So do not hot glue on top of the rubber band because it may melt it and it will break and then you'll have to start all over. So this is for the clip version, and I'll show you the interchangeable bow option in the next video. But we want the clip to sit on top of this first layer of fabric. So I'm gonna wrap this around and then I'm gonna put my clip in just so that I make sure I don't hot glue anywhere I want the clip to go. This technique isn't necessary if you're just gonna hot glue this onto a headband or onto Mickey ears. So you don't need to do this. You can just hot glue it down. But if you want this to have a clip on it, so that it's interchangeable either in hair or a hair tie or a headband, then this is a really great option to do that. So then I just cut off this little excess piece right here and I try to pull it down a little bit so that it's not exposed on the front. And then I go over the raw edge just barely with the tip of my hot glue gun just to kind of clean up any fray marks. And then that is it.